I realized that most people have no idea about what really will bring them accomplishment. And that's why last week we were talking about how I define success, picking from Maxwell's definition of success, where you identify your purpose in life, you grow to your maximum potential in that particular purpose, and then you sow seeds that would benefit others. You see, it's not just about you, it's about other people. Even your service, growing to your max, means you are offering some service for which you were born. And now, looking at this section where we are talking about the head is the tail and mission for a business, you realize that people set up businesses and their sole consideration is, how much am I going to earn? You see? And most times, like us in Kenya, we get business presentation in terms of, if you put this, you get this. You get, you meet these statements about farming. You take maybe 3 acres in Narok, you put ngano in, it costs you this much in 3 months, or in 6 months, you get this much. And people rush to it. Afterwards, they collapse. They've lost money, and people keep losing money again and again. You'll realize the other day, I've been running some mentorship in Kajiado, meeting business people and working together with them. And the business, the survey that the client did, the Equity Bank did before and recorded, whatever the businesses they recorded for them, that so and so is probably running a restaurant. This one running a transport business. If you go there, you realize that 99% they are not doing that particular business. And whatever was recorded, they've changed like 2-3 times. Why? Because they pick a business based on how much return can I get. They pick a business based on what a friend said. They pick a business based on whom some other relative whom they see doing well in it. People do not choose things depending on what is in their heart. What service do they want to offer to the society to grow to their max and sow seeds that will always benefit others? It's a big deal. It's a big problem. That's why most people don't live full. They are always grumbling. They are always finding life difficult. They push themselves to do things they do not want to do. They don't have fun doing what they are supposed to do. And that's why we are talking about sport. It's not their sport. They are doing it for money. And even if you are working somewhere, you are employed somewhere, but your only relationship with that particular task is money, you are not having any fulfillment, any fun, you're not feeling like you're accomplishing something, you're going to collapse. You're not going to be fulfilled. You will quit. You will somewhat feel like it's not worth it. Why? It's been realized by research, money can never be a motivation enough. If we are pursuing something just because of money, it won't work. It won't last. We must find a higher meaning, a bigger meaning, a more important meaning beyond the money. Money becomes the byproduct. And so in choosing an enterprise, we've got to be people who are choosing what is it that is going to resonate with my heart? What is it that whenever I'm doing it, I'm going to feel like I'm really being of service to the community? And in this case, by so doing, we are going to be a people who are living fully. We are going to be feeling even healthier, feeling more satisfied. In fact, it said, it might not matter how much money we're earning, because the first earning that we're getting is the money, is the opportunity to be able to participate in that particular task, in that particular labor. And by the way, that is what makes us more creative, because passion begets creativity. And there is nothing much we can do if we are not passionate, if we are not creative. And we cannot be passionate or creative if we are pursuing a course that does not rhyme with our hearts. So that was the idea in my mind. We've got, if every individual we're meeting on earth today was able to get his or her particular mission, the predetermined mission, whatever we were equipped to do, then the world would be much, much better. We would be meeting much more happier people. This heartbreaking and all the emotional problems, all the mental issues would come to an end, by the way. Because we will all be fulfilled. Our work will be much more therapeutic. And so each one of us, it's important that we individually identify that for which we were called to do. And even if we are setting up organizations, they should be related to that. The other day, I think discussing this with another friend of mine. And looking at it, we realize that in most cases, people do not want to think beyond the selfish gain. They keep thinking with respect to what is in it for me. What is in it for me? If we give service for the good of giving it and because we feel satisfied giving it, then things are going to be much, much better. Thank you.